Okay, good afternoon to everyone. Good afternoon, ma'am. So, our team consists of myself, Divyashri, Harshita, Pragna, and Charadi. So, we are going to present a presentation on role based classifiers. So, introduction. The learned model is represented as a set of if-then rules. So we'll be learning about if-then rules, and rules are first examined on how to use them for the classification. Then what we'll do is the ways in which the rules can be generated is understood. So all the ways, we will first learn the if-then rules, and then all the ways that can be extracted and used, all those things we'll be learning in this presentation. And this particular thing is done, I mean the ways are learned either from the decision tree or directly from training data using a sequential covering algorithm. Okay, so moving on to Harshita. Harshita?
Now let us know about if-then rules for classification. Rule-based classifier makes use of a set of if-then rules for classification. If-then rule is an expression of the form if condition then conclusion. If part of the rule is called rule antecedent or precondition, then part of the rule or right hand side of the rule is called as rule consequent. For example, if age is youth and student is S, then by the computer. The if part consists of the condition which contains one or more attribute tests, and these tests are logically ANDed. Then part consists of class predictions. Joshi, next slide. A rule R can be assessed by its coverage and accuracy. Given a tuple X from a class labeled data set D, let N covers be the number of tuples covered by R, and N correct be the number of tuples correctly classified by R, and modulus of D be the number of tuples in D. We can define the coverage and accuracy of R as coverage of R is equal to N covers divided by modulus of D. Accuracy of R is equal to N correct divided by N covers. A rule's coverage is the percentage of tuples that are covered by the rule. That means coverage is a fraction of records that satisfy the antecedent of a rule. For a rule's accuracy, we look at the tuple that is covered and see what percentage of them the rule can correctly classify. And accuracy means the fraction of records covered by the rule that belong to the class on the RHS. Further, Divya will continue.
Hello everyone, I'm Divyashri. Let's move on with the if-then rules for classification. Here I have a class labeled tuples from the All Electronics customer database. Here there are 14 tuples. Next slide. Next slide.
Yeah, just wait.
So in this our task,
I would have changed the slide 30 seconds ago, but then it reflects in your system little later. So please be patient while the screen is sharing. I mean, the slide is just getting changed.
Okay. Let's look at the example. Here our task is to predict whether a customer will buy a computer or not. By considering the rule R1, age is equal to youth and student is equal to yes, then buys computer is equal to yes. The previous slide. So we need to map this rule R1 with the tuple we have. Tuples are nothing but the samples we have.
Shall I move on?
Previous slide.
Okay, just a minute.
So in this, by considering the rule 1, we map the tuple number 9 and 11, which matches both, satisfies the condition of both age is equal to youth and student is equal to yes. So there are two matches of the tuple. Next slide.
Just wait, I've changed, it will reflect.
So this is what it says. It classifies both the tuples. As Harshita discussed the formula, by applying the formula coverage R is equal to n covers divided by number of tuples in D. By applying the formula, which is equal to 2 divided by 14 is equal to 14.28%. And the accuracy, the formula is n correct divided by n covers. So two tuples are correctly matched. Therefore, accuracy is equal to 2 divided by 2 is equal to 100%. So by taking another example, X is equal to age is equal to youth, income is equal to medium, student is equal to yes, credit rating is equal to far. In this, if the rule is satisfied by X, then the rule is said to be triggered. Therefore, the X satisfies R1, which triggers the rule. If R1 is the only rule satisfied, then the rule fires by returning the class prediction for X. If more than one rule is triggered, we need a conflict resolution strategy to figure out which rule has to be fired and assign its class prediction to X. Next slide. Moving on to size ordering and rule ordering. Size ordering scheme is nothing but we are assigning the highest priority to the triggering rule that has the toughest requirements. Here, toughness is measured by rule antecedent size. Next one, rule ordering scheme. It prioritizes the rule beforehand. In this rule ordering, we can classify it as two types, class-based and rule-based. With class-based ordering, we are sorting it in the order of decreasing importance, such as by decreasing order of prevalence. Prevalence is nothing but most frequently. That is, whichever the class comes first, will classify it. Then the rules for the next prevalent class come next, and so on. Now, the rule-based ordering. The rules are organized into one long priority list according to some measure of rule quality, like accuracy, coverage, or size, or from based on the domain experts. Next, when the rule ordering is used, the rule set is known as the decision list. When no rule is satisfied by X, default rules are called. Like, they are the rules to specify a default class based on a training set. So when the condition in the default rule is empty, we fire the rule as default rule. Moving on, Abhinandan will be continuing it.
Okay, so now we have got an idea of what this if then rule says. What we'll do now is we'll learn about the rule extraction from a decision tree. So what this particular rule extraction is all about is, first, we actually make use of this if-then rules for classification. Then
Abhinandan, share screen.
Sorry, I think there's a problem. Okay, there are some technical problems with this.
We can see.
Okay. So decision tree classifiers are considered one of the popular methods of classification due to their simple work and accuracy. So they are very simple, and also there is high level of accuracy. So what we do is we usually use this decision tree classifier, and we actually build a rule-based classifier by extracting if-then rules from a decision tree. There is a particular decision tree, and from that we usually extract the if-then rules. So there is one disadvantage. What that is, the one disadvantage of this decision tree is that sometimes the decision tree can become large and difficult to interpret. So such things are usually a little bit difficult to interpret, and sometimes they may go wrong. So in that case, decision tree is too large. So if-then rules may be easier to understand then the decision tree for humans. So now we got to know, first we learned about if-then rules, and then we got to know how we are extracting rules from the decision tree and why if-then rules is very important. So moving on to that, let us now learn about the working of this decision tree. So to extract rules from a decision tree, one rule is created for each path from the root of the leaf node. So there is a root node, and there is a rule created for that. So So what happens is each splitting creation along a given path is logically ANDed. So this logically AND it has been logically ANDed and to form a rule antecedent, that is if part. And the leaf node holds the class prediction, forming the rule consequent. So there is if part that is antecedent, and then there is the then part that is consequent. So the disjunction, so that the nothing but the logical OR that is implemented between each of the extracted rules. As the rules are extracted directly from tree, they are mutually exclusive and exhaustive. So exclusive, we already know. The exhaustive, I think it's a little bit new word. So I'd like to just give an explanation about exhaustive. If we consider a person to be an adult, for example, let us consider some person to be an adult. There are only two things. Either he is an adult or he is not an adult. There is no other choice. Like if it is one, either it is one or it is not one. There is nothing else in between. So that is actually the exact meaning of this exhaustive. So since we end up with one rule per leaf, the set of extracted rules does not end up being simpler than the corresponding decision tree. In fact, in some cases, the extracted rules may be even more difficult to interpret than the original trees. So what happens is this difficulty we may face when the extracted rules will be a little bit difficult to interpret than the original trees. Sometimes it happens sometimes that once you start processing and it becomes difficult to interpret rather than the original ones, we feel that original ones are the easier ones. I mean, it's very simpler ones. Such things usually happen once we start processing from the extracting the rules from decision tree and then processing. So the resulting set of rules extracted can be large and difficult to follow because some of the attributes in the test may be irrelevant or redundant. Okay, so moving on. Hence, pruning the resulting rule set is required. So what is pruning over here? There is something called as pruning, which means in a particular decision tree, the unwanted things are removed or they're just scrapped off to make it a simpler one than to make it more complicated. This is actually the meaning of pruning. So here is an example. For given rule antecedent, any condition that does not improve the estimated accuracy of the rule can be pruned. So whatever is not actually required and which will not improve the accuracy, it can actually be scrapped off. And then the particular decision tree becomes simpler. So the training tuples and their associated class labels are used to estimate rule accuracy. In addition, what we do is any rule that does not contribute to the overall accuracy of the entire rule set can also be pruned. So here the pruning is actually more communicated in terms of the accuracy. So what I mean to say over here is there is pruning, and whatever that does not contribute to the accuracy or sometimes which drops the accuracy can easily be pruned. So the problem that arises during rule pruning is the rules will no longer be mutually exclusive and exhaustive. So this exclusive, first we learned that it should be mutually exclusive and exhaustive. But since the decision trees become a little more complex when they are processed, we followed the process of pruning. Now we encountered another problem. What the problem is, once they are pruned, these are no longer mutually exclusive and exhaustive. So to resolve this, a class-based ordering scheme can be adopted. So we came across different problems, and to solve one problem, there is another problem arising. Now we finally came to this class-based ordering scheme. So what this class-based ordering scheme is, we'll just go about it. It actually groups together all the rules for a single class and then determines a ranking of these class rule sets. Within a rule set, the rules are not ordered. So this is, I think, little important. And the class rule sets are made such that they minimize the number of false positive errors. And then the class rule set with the least number of false positive is examined first. So they are first, ordered. And then what they do is the false positive errors will be taken care. And then the class rule set which has the least number of false positive, they are first examined. Once the pruning is complete, final check is done to remove any duplicates. So by this way, we can actually make sure that the rules will be mutually exclusive and exhaustive. So the duplicates are also removed, and now by completing all these processes, the decision tree would be clean and neat, and only the rules that contribute to the accuracy would have remained. So the class that contains the most training tuples that are not covered by any rule is selected for this. So moving on, Pradnya will continue.
Good afternoon, everyone. Abhinandan, I actually can't see the screen. Okay, now I can see. Thank you.
Okay, is it?
Okay. Yeah, yeah, we can. Yeah, see. Yeah, it's visible now. Good. The rule extraction from a decision tree using this example. This example is basically to determine, this data tells us whether a person will buy a computer or not based on his age. And there are three main age groups which are defined in this decision tree, that is youth, middle-aged, and senior. Now we can create or extract rules using this decision tree by tracing the path from the root node to the leaf nodes. Now let us take a look one by one by tracing the paths. Now, age. If a person is youth, is he a student? It will check if he's a student. Now, if he is a student, then he'll obviously need a computer, so he will buy a computer. But if that person is not a student, then he won't buy a computer. Now, if the person is a middle-aged man, he will definitely buy a computer. There is no if-then branch with this age group. Whereas, if he's a senior citizen, the decision tree will check for his credit rating. If the person's credit rating is fair, he will not buy the computer, but if his credit rating is excellent, he will definitely buy the computer. Now these conditions can be put and reframed by using the terms if, then, and or to create rules. Next slide, Abhinandan.
Okay, wait a minute. Is it load?
Yeah. As I explained from the decision tree before, you can see. Yes. Can you guys hear me?
Yes. Yes. Continue.
Yeah, I'm hearing.
As we saw from the decision tree before, this is the same. Yes.
Continue, Pradnya. Continue.
As we saw from the decision tree before. This is just the rule representation of the same tracing. As you see, yes?
I think there is a delay when it is when the whole audio is reaching to her. Pradnya, you can continue. There is no problem.
No.
Ma'am, just wait a minute. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. Network issues, I think.
Hello.
Hello. We can hear you.
Yes, ma'am. I'll continue. I think there is a delay, but I'll come.
Yeah, yeah. It's okay.
Now we saw from the decision tree, the same tracing leads to these rules that are formed here. As from the decision tree, we can create the first rule that if the person is a youth, it will check if it's a student, and if he is not a student, he will not buy a computer because he doesn't need it. Whereas if he is a youth and he is a student, he will buy the computer. Also, rule 3 tells that if a person is middle-aged, then he'll definitely buy a computer. There is no or branching in this rule. Rule 4 tells us that if the person is a senior citizen and his credit rating is excellent, then he will buy a computer. If that senior citizen's credit rating is fair, that is not as good as it needs to be, then he will not buy a computer. And this is represented by rule 5. Thank you. Next will be continued by Sharadi.
Abhinandan.
No, no, I've changed. I think it is taking time to reflect.
That's no, this video, no, yes. Video, no, you send it to me so that I will upload in Google Classroom so that other students can also access.
Sure, ma'am, sure. There will be any delay?
Hello?
Yes, Sharadi.
Can I? Okay. So, coming up to the sequential covering algorithm, this can be used to extract if and then rules form of training data. So, we do not require to generate a decision tree first. In this algorithm, each rule for a given class covers many of the tuples of that particular class. So, there are some sequential covering algorithms. They are AQ, CN2, and RIPER. Next slide.
Yeah, I have changed.
So, the working strategies of an algorithm is as follows. As per the general strategy, the rules are learned one at a time. For each time, rules are learned, a tuple covered by the rule is removed and the process continues for the rest of the tuples. This is because the path of the each leaf in decision tree corresponds to a rule. So here the decision tree induction can be considered as learning a set of rules simultaneously. So here the rules are learned for one class at a time. When learning a rule from a class CI, we want the rule to cover all the tuples from class C only, and no tuple from any other class. So this algorithm is given as follows. So first, we are going to give the input as D. D is nothing but the data set class labeled tuples. And attribute values, the set of all attributes and other possible values will be there. So the output will be in this format, like we are extracting the if and then rules from this algorithm. So first, in first method, for the rule set variable, we are going to give some set of rules which has been, initially it will be empty. We are going to add some rules over there.
Maybe it will go in the end, I think so.
No, Abhinandan. Ma'am. No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Yeah.
It's been extended, ma'am.
No, ma'am. Not an issue, ma'am. It won't end, ma'am. It won't end.
So, next, for each class C, we do repeat the same process. Again, we will assign one particular rule with all the data set class and attribute values with one particular class. And we are going to remove the tuples covered by rule from the data set class which has been labeled, and until the until this loop is executed, until it is terminated, and the rule set variable will be containing the rule set along with the rule. We are going to add a new rule to a rule set, so this process continues. So through this algorithm we are going to extract if and then rules. So next will be continued by Pradnya.
Good afternoon again, everyone. Now, any rule that is created, it must be measured for its quality. Now, there are certain tests which measure the quality of a rule. If you consider an attribute test to measure the quality of a rule, it must be checked such that if appending that test to the current rule, will the condition of the rule improve? If the rule is not getting improved, then there is no point in adding the test, and you can maintain the current state of the rule. Also, this rule, when it is applied on a, also this test, when it is applied on a rule, it doesn't have to be applied while the rule is getting evaluated. It is in fact applied when the when it is applied with the tuples from the original training data. And applying this test on this data make sure that positive or optimistic results are given. That is, the improved rules will be the resultant of this test, because the rules will likely overfit the data when it is assessed with tuples from the original training data. Thank you.
Hello.
Yes, madam. We are done with the.
What do you? Yeah. Presentation was good, actually.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Have you covered full syllabus of rule based classifier?
Madam, whatever topic yes, that we had chosen, we have covered that. Not.
Yeah, that's what one small portion of the from the classification that module. No, small yes. Portion is the rule based classifier. Okay. Yes. Have you referred that textbook?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Have you seen that?